Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PHP, that is PHP 8.0.11 in Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install the latest version of PHP, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply type PHP download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.php.net is basically our first search result. So just, you know, simply click on downloads PHP. And this will, you know, going to redirect you to this official site of PHP. You can see this is basically the official site, and you can see the latest release is 8.0.11, right? So in here, since we are going to download it for Windows, so I'm just, you know, simply go, I'm going to click on this Windows download. So just, you know, simply click on that. And this is going to redirect you to this windows.php.net page. So I'll be putting this entire link in the description, so you can just directly navigate to this page over here, right? And in here you need to just simply scroll down a bit till this thread safe options, right? So just, you know, go to this thread safe, and then just, you know, simply click on this zip file, so that it will, you know, going to download. So you can see it has, you know, rightly started downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see the latest version of PHP, that is PHP 8.0.11, has been rightly downloaded over here. So just, you know, simply right click on it, and then just, you know, simply click on this extract all. And then you'll be seeing this window. So just, you know, simply check this, and then just simply click on extract. And you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly started extracting our PHP 8.0.11. So it has, you know, rightly extracted, and our PHP 8.0.11 all files you can clearly see over here. So just, you know, simply close it. And this is basically our extracted file, right? So just, you know, simply rename it. So you can rename it by just, you know, simply right click on it, and then just simply click on rename. So just, you know, simply rename it to till 11. So PHP dash 8.0.11, right? So we are just renaming it to a shorter name. And then just, you know, simply right click on it, and then just simply click on copy. And now you need to just simply go to your C drive, then right click on it and paste. So what we are doing is, we are first simply downloading our PHP, then going to extract it, and then we are going to rename it. And then after renaming, we are just, you know, simply copy that folder, and we are pasting in our C drive, right? So that's pretty much all about the installation. Now we need to set our environment path. So for that, just simply click on this tool icon, and here just simply type environ. And you'll be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just, you know, simply click on that, and this is, you know, going to open this window. In here you need to just simply click on environment variables, and then you need to just simply click on path, then edit, then new. In here we are going to paste a path, right? So just again go back to our C drive, then just simply go inside this PHP 8.0.11 folder, then just simply click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. So just copy this path, right? Again, I go back to our environment settings. So in environment, edit environment variable, just again simply click on new, and then right click on it and paste. So you are going to paste the C:\PHP-8.0.11 folder over here, right? So this path, and then just simply click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK, right? And you can always close this. Now again, if you just simply click on this search icon, and here if you just simply type cmd, you'll be getting this command prompt. Just open your command prompt, and now if you just simply type php space dash dash version, then enter, you can clearly see the latest version of PHP, that is PHP 8.0.11, has been rightly installed on our machine. Now I am going to also show you how we can easily run any PHP Hello World program in your command prompt itself. So for that, let us first open our Notepad++. So I have already shown you a simple Hello World program in Java, so that is currently open. So I just close it, and now here I'm going to, you know, show you a simple PHP code snippet. So this angular bracket PHP, and then we are going to echo just a Hello World. So, you know, hello world, and then just simply go to file, then save as, and this is, you know, and this will, you know, going to open this window. So you go to your document directory, then create a new folder. So PHP practice, let's give a name, go inside that folder, and let's give a file name as prog, right? And here you need to save this file as all file type and give extension as .php, right? So since you are coding in PHP, so give .php extension and save as type to all file type, right? So this is a very important step. So do that and then just simply click on save, right? And you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly saved over here, right? And now all you need to do is you need to just simply navigate to that folder. So this document folder, then PHP practice folder, then you need to just, you know, simply click on this address bar, then cmd, then enter, and you'll be getting your command prompt rightly open right at your document slash PHP practice folder. So here our prog.php file is currently lying. Now to run, all you need to do is you need to just, you know, simply type php, then you need to provide your file name, so that is prog.php, right? And then just simply click on enter, and you can clearly see the output hello world has been rightly shown in our console, right? So in this way you can easily install the latest version of PHP, that is PHP 8.0.11 in Windows 10 operating system. I have rightly shown you how to download the PHP and then how to extract, how to set the environment variables, and finally I have also shown you how to write a simple PHP hello world code snippet in your Notepad plus plus, and then how to run in our console, right? So you can easily do that in this way, but it is always recommended to use this XAMPP software. So if you just, you know, simply type XAMPP over here, XAMPP download, in this apachefriends.org, you'll be getting this basically XAMPP folder. So I have already made a detailed video on how to install XAMPP in our Windows 10 operating system. So since PHP is a server-side language, so it is always recommended to use a server to code PHP. You can always, you know, for the initially starting period, you can use command prompt, that's totally fine. But since PHP actually used at the server side, so it is always recommended to use a server, right? So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and also please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.